with top rank in ESPN?
I heard about that this morning.
Mikey just told me about that one.
You didn't know about it?
I'm surprised. Because I thought they were going to do the Wilder rematch like sometime soon this year.
I found out this morning.
I don't think that's going to happen after all. It's going to be harder.
It's going to be challenging.
It might be a little more difficult to get done. Because again, look, see, now you got opposing networks and handlers and promoters and whatever. And that sometimes that's a little more challenging, you know, because you got two A-side fighters that on their own, they can generate, you know, I mean, for easy numbers, let's say they both can generate $5 million each on their own. You know, yes, they can make more money together, but the promoters sometimes don't really get along on the terms, or the managers, or whoever it may be. The fighter wants to go, you know, 50-50 when one of them says 45-55, and that's it. It doesn't get done. It won't get done. So it's a little harder to get stuff done than when they were both on the same page and same, you know, team of people.
Well, Top Rank have one heavyweight they signed named Pulev. He's Bulgarian.
Okay.
So that could be a possible fight in March at the Forum.
That's probably what they're going to do.
Wants to see one.
Pulev?
Pulev. He has a brother also fought. He's a Pulev. Character. Pulev. A big personality.
It really sucks because honestly, like, after the first fight they had, Wilder and Fury, everybody wanted to see a rematch. Yeah. Everybody wants to see a rematch. Now it's going to be hard because, you know, with ESPN and Fox or something,
gonna be hard.
That kind of sucks.
But see, he'll fight that guy Pulev or whatever at the Forum or wherever they fight.
It must have been a fucking really, really good offer, because Fury, you know, people are gonna think he ran away from that fight, right?
Yeah,
it could be. People could think he found a way not to fight.
If he was close to getting it done,
he was
now
close to
sign something else. I mean, everybody knows. No secret that it's hard to get those fights done against, you know, different promoters. It's just hard. But, you know.
But, I mean, it still could happen, but it's much more...
It might take a little longer.
Yeah, exactly.
It might take longer because they both fight one or two fights in between until they get each other.
And they have to make sure they don't lose, otherwise...
You know, it's tough. It's tough.
Hey, speaking of big heavyweights, Chris Arreola is fighting on your card.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
I like Chris.
Yeah, Chris is a good dude. Henry, they're good people, man. I'm happy.
They're real cool. Yeah, they're cool guys. I met them when we first came to Riverside 8-9 years ago. They allowed us to come into their gym, to Indians gym, where Henry was training Jose and Chris.
Where you had those bulldogs humping the heavy bags.
Tank.
Yeah.
I forget the other guy's name. What was that?
I remember back then Robert didn't like dogs. And one time they let the dogs in the gym, he jumped in the ring
to the ropes too.
And now Robert has two dogs,
Ted and Pepsi. Nah, but yeah, they're you know, Henry and Chris are very cool.
Nady. Nady's fighting the Puerto Rican. What's his name?
Benavides
is a cool man.
And then I just realized this Saturday on the fight night,